Good morning. In the last lecture, we talked about one-dimensional box, energy quantization. We have completed this article in the last lecture. And next article is one-dimensional box wave function. The last lecture, I think L is left somewhere. While getting equation 6, we use this one. Squaring both sides, we got and therefore En is equal to the last lecture, this L square was not taken here. Make correction to equation 6 in energy quantization. We have taken this one here, we have not taken it here. When we square both sides, this L will come here as L square, and consequently it should come here in the denominator. Make this correction. And even in the last equation, 2m E1 this L was also left there in the last equation. So do these two corrections. After this equation, this L should appear here as L square in this equation, and this En will be, transfer this 2m L square this side, it will come here, and this h cross square to this side, it will come here. So the energy level will be En is equal to n square pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square, and this momentum of the first energy level according to uncertainty principle for E is not equal to 0. P1 is equal to plus or minus square root of 2m E1, that is nothing but pi h cross divided by L. This also derived from the same equation. H cross is taken to this side, it can be taken outside. What left to this side is 2me inside the square root is equal to n pi h cross divided by L. When we take n is equal to 1, this will be momentum p1, that is 2me1 inside the square root. N has become 1, let us write plus or minus pi h cross divided by L. So this L was also left. So add this L square here in equation 6 in the denominator, and this L in the last equation of energy quantization. Do these two corrections. Let us move to the next article of this chapter. It is again one-dimensional box. Wave function. Next article of this unit, one-dimensional box wave function. So what we consider, we shall consider the same figure that we have drawn in the last article, one dimensional box of width capital L. One particle trapped inside this box, it is set into motion only along x axis. The walls of this box are infinitely hard, and therefore potential energy of the particle inside the box will be zero, outside the box infinite. So the box could not leave, the particle could not leave the box. It will lie inside the box only, performing motion along x-axis, and therefore there is a wave function psi associated with this particle. In the last lecture, we shown that energy of this particle is quantized. It can have only discrete values of energy E1, E2, E3, E4, etc. given by equation number 6 of the last article. Then what should be the wave function corresponding to this particle? Wave function corresponding to this particle, we may write this as psi n is equal to, this is nothing but the solution that we considered earlier, sine two m e divided by h cross square. Let me put this as e n, as I have taken psi as psi n, e as e n. So for energy e n, psi function will be psi n. If energy is e 1, psi function will be psi 1. Energy e 2, psi function psi 2. Energy e 3, psi n psi 3, and so on into x, right? Equation number 1. But from the energy quantization equation, we got En is equal to n square pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square, equation number 2. Let us substitute this value of En from equation 2 in equation 1 here, so that the wave function psi n will be a sine of 2m divided by h cross square into n square pi square h cross square divided by 2m L square, this whole inside the square root into x, then this 2m, this 2m get cancel, this h cross square get cancel, what left inside the square root is n square pi square by L square. Let us take out this outside the square root to get psi n is equal to a sine n pi by L into x, equation number 3. Equation 3 gives the wave function psi n of the particle trapped in one dimensional box. Equation 3 gives the wave function psi n trapped in the one dimensional box. This wave function psi n is known as energy wave function. This wave function psi n is known as energy wave function. As energy is quantized, this wave function psi n is also quantized. Quantized in the sense, this will have different values depending on the value of n. As n changes, psi n will also change. So values of this psi n will in accordance with n, the principal quantum number. This wave function psi n should be acceptable wave function. This should obey the boundary conditions. This should obey the Schrodinger equation, and moreover, it should be acceptable wave function. Acceptable wave function psi n should be continuous. It should be finite. It should be single valued. Differentiation of psi n. Differentiation of psi n should be continuous. One thing. Second thing, it should be finite. And third thing, it should be single valued. If these conditions are obeyed by this wave function psi n, then only it will be the acceptable wave function. Once it is acceptable wave function, the system under consideration will be stable system, and it can be solved for quantized energies. The wave function psi n will be finite if we integrate. It can be seen if we integrate this over the boundaries of the system under consideration. What is the system under consideration? One dimensional box is the system under consideration. What are the boundary conditions? Boundary conditions for the one dimensional box are x is equal to 0 and x is equal to capital L. Let us try to find the probability density of this particle, taking into consideration this wave function psi n inside the one dimensional box. And we have to show that this probability should be finite. It should be equal to 1. If this is true, then only psi n will be the acceptable wave function. So let me write the probability P is equal to integration in the limits minus infinity to plus infinity square of modulus of psi n into dx, general equation for probability density. For our condition of one dimensional box, this equation will be P is equal to, limits are 0 to capital L. What is the psi n? It is this. Psi star will be same, and therefore it will be a square psi square of n pi by L into x into dx, equation number 4. Sin square theta is 1 minus cos 2 theta whole divided by 2. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Let us use this identity, this formula for this sin square of this angle in equation 4, so that this probability density P will be integration in the limit 0 to L. Let me take this a side outside, 1 minus cos 2 times n pi divided by L into x, this whole divided by 2 into dx. This is further a square into 1 by 2x minus sine 2n pi by L into x one by two times. Limits are 0 to L. This will be simply 1 by 2 L for the higher limit. For lower limit, it will be 0, first term. What about the second term? For higher limit, x is L. 2 N times pi multiplied by anything. It will be N pi, for which sine is 0. And for 0, it is 0. So for both these limits, the second term is going to 0. And we here have simply p is equal to a square into 1 by 2 into capital L, equation number 5. The wave function psi n should be normalized. Let us try to normalize the wave function psi. How to normalize the wave function psi? P is equal to integration over minus infinity to plus infinity psi n square dx. What is meaning of this? You are searching for the particle in the space from minus infinity to plus infinity to find the probability density, to find presence of the particle in the free space, in the space from minus infinity to plus infinity. If the particle is there in the space from minus infinity to plus infinity, this integration should be equal to 1. The probability will be finite and maximum probability will be equal to 1. We are applying this for the limit 0 to capital L, and we have actually trapped a particle inside the one dimensional box from the limit 0 to capital L, and therefore value of this P should be equal to 1, and this is true. If P is 1, it means that the particle you have trapped in the one-dimensional box is actually present, is actually lying inside the one-dimensional box. And therefore, we should have P is equal to 1. Equation number 6. Compare 5 and 6. If you compare 5 and 6, we will simply have A square into 1 by 2 L is equal to 1, or A square is equal to 2 divided by L, or A is equal to square root of 2 divided by L, equation number 7. A is equal to square root of 2 divided by L, equation 7. Let us substitute this value of A as square root of 2 divided by L from equation 7 into, I think, equation 2. We already wrote for psi n is equal to this equation, A sine n pi by L into x. In this equation, let us put A is equal to this. So, this psi n will be equal to square root of 2 divided by L sine n pi by L into x, equation number 8. It is the normalized wave function for the particle trapped in a one-dimensional box between the boundaries x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L. This is the wave function for the particle trapped in a one-dimensional box. The wave function psi n and corresponding probability p. The wave function psi n in equation 8 and the corresponding probability may be given by this equation can be drawn graphically. Let us draw it graphically. X is equal to 0, X is equal to L, psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, it may be continued. Similarly, we may draw a figure for probability density. X is equal to 0, X is equal to L, P1, so the figures are drawn for wave function psi and the probability p. For the first energy level, this is the wave function. For the second energy level, this is the wave function. For third energy level, this is the wave function. We can continue for higher and higher energy levels of the particle. And what do we find? The energy the wave function is not same for all energy levels. Wave function is different for different energy levels. What do we see here? The wave function is maximum at the middle for first energy level. For the second energy level, the wave function is maximum at 1/4 L, maximum positive at 1/4 L, maximum negative at 3/4 L, 1/4 L, 3/4 L. If we go to third energy level, what do we find? Wave function is maximum at 1/6 L, at maximum positive at 1/6 L, maximum negative at 1/2 L, and maximum positive again at 5/6 of L. Wave function is different for different energy levels. The wave function may be positive, it may be negative. But we find positive here, positive here, positive here, positive here. Negative here, negative here. It is changing continuously. Everywhere for every energy level, wave function is zero at x is equal to zero. Wave function is zero at x is equal to L. And in between, it varies. At some places, the wave function may be positive. At some places, the wave function may be negative, depending on the energy level. Let us come to this. This P1 is this one. Modulus of psi 1, square of modulus of psi 1. P2 is square of modulus of psi 2. P3 is square of modulus of psi 3, and so on. What do you find here? The probability is maximum at the center, at the middle. Wave function may be negative or positive. It may have negative values as well as positive values. Probability is not allowed to have negative values. Zero, zero, positive, increasing from zero, maximum positive decreases, come to zero, again start increasing, become maximum positive, decreases to zero, again maximum positive. This is zero level, this is zero level, it is not so. This is zero level, this is zero level, this is zero level. Positive, negative, only positive. Positive, negative, positive. This is not the case for moment, the probability density. Zero, zero, zero. Probability density is not allowed to have negative value. The wave function can have negative values, but the probability density cannot have negative value. Least value of probability density is zero. It is zero at x is equal to zero. It is zero at x is equal to L. For first energy level, it is zero only at x is equal to zero, x is equal to L, and it is increasing, becomes maximum at the center, decreasing, comes to zero. Not allowed to go below zero. For the second energy level, it is zero at x is equal to zero. Increasing, becomes maximum, decreasing, becomes zero at the middle for second energy level. And here for first energy level, at the middle it is maximum positive. From zero again increasing, becomes maximum, decreasing, becomes zero at x is equal to L. Different is the case here for third energy level. Zero at x is equal to zero, increasing, becomes negative, maximum positive here at 1/6 of L, decreasing, becomes zero here at 1/3 of capital L, start increasing, becomes maximum at 1/2 L, decreasing, becomes zero at 2/3 of L, increasing, becomes maximum at 5/6 of L, decreasing, becomes zero at x is equal to L. So if we compare the wave functions corresponding to various energy levels and corresponding probabilities corresponding to again various energy levels, what we find, the wave function can be positive, it can be negative. The wave function can have positive values, the wave function can also have negative values. Variation of the wave function for first energy level is shown here. Variation of the wave function for second energy level is shown here. Variation of the wave function for third energy level is shown here. This may be continued. And what do we see? The variation is different for different energy levels. And it is such that these wave functions can have positive values as well as negative values. But if we go for the probabilities, what we find? Probability is allowed to have only positive value. The minimum value for probability density is 0. 0, not smaller than 0. Okay. And these values of probability densities are again different at different places for the same particle in a different energy levels. These probability densities for the same particle are different at different places in different energy levels. Maximum here at the middle, at the center for first energy level, whereas for second energy level it is 0 here at the same position. Instead it is maximum somewhere here and somewhere here. Different is the case for the third energy level. It is maximum here, maximum here, maximum here, 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, 0 here, in between increasing, become maximum, decreasing, increasing, becomes maximum, decreasing, and so on. So this is how the wave function, this is how the wave function of the same particle in one dimensional box varies in accordance with this figure, and it can have positive or negative values. Whereas if you go for corresponding probabilities, we find that probability is not allowed to take negative value. Least value probability is 0. It can have 0 or positive values only. It is not allowed to have negative values. And these values are again different for the same particle for different energy levels. For the first energy level, the maximum possibility of finding the particle is at the middle. Whereas for second energy level, maximum possibility of finding the particle is here and here. For the third energy level, maximum probability of finding the particle is here or here or here. So the probabilities of the same particle, finding of the particle in the one dimensional box is different for different energy levels. Okay, so this is about one dimensional box wave function. Hope you got it. We have derived necessary mathematical part and the wave functions and corresponding probability densities for the same particle trapped in one dimensional box for different energy levels are shown in this figure. You may call this as figure 1, you may call this as figure 2. This figure 1 gives variation of the energy wave function, variation of energy wave function for different energy levels, and figure 2 gives variation of the probability density of the particle trapped in a one dimensional box in different energy levels. This is about the one dimensional box wave function, and this wave function is known as energy wave function. Hope you got it. Thank you.